how complex are global food supply chains? Very. We tend to think of global supply chains as a straight line from the farm to the consumer. Supply chains are a web of actors that are producing your inputs, your tools, and then of course the farmer who's producing the crop, warehousing, transportation, processing, branding, packaging, and then finally retailing and the consumer. Last year, we really stepped up our efforts in terms of identifying concrete ways that we can decarbonize across our supply chains, in particular using nature-based solutions to feed the growing population of this planet and to meet the food security and the nutrition needs of our population. My name is Julie Greene, and I'm Chief Sustainability Officer at Olam Agri. Olam Agri's mission is to transform food, feed, and fiber for a more sustainable and food secure future. Underpinning sustainable agri-food systems are healthy soils. There are amazing benefits to the technological advances that we saw during the 20th century. But unfortunately, these advances came with some detrimental impacts to soil health as well. So today we need regenerative practices that incorporate more natural systems, that really blend the best of traditional and conventional practices. There's a whole list of major challenges facing agricultural supply chains: deforestation, soil degradation, human rights risks, declining yields, biodiversity loss. We're observing that regenerative agriculture can contribute to improved yields and improved resilience. Through our climate smart and regenerative rice farming programs in Thailand, Vietnam, and India, we've seen that regenerative agriculture practices can really positively impact farmers' yields and incomes while also reducing their carbon emissions. We've been supporting almost 500,000 smallholder farmers to improve their farming practices and their livelihoods, implementing sustainable processing practices in our factories, and providing certified sustainable and fortified food products to the world. In order for farmers to transition to regenerative farming practices, they need to have the knowledge, the means, and the motivation to make that transition. If we want to limit global warming to about 1.5 degrees above pre-industrial levels, we would need to increase the land under regenerative agricultural practices from about 15% today to about 40% by 2030. We need sourcing models and incentive systems that help to share the cost of this transition across the supply chain and that reward farmers that are implementing regenerative practices. This can include price premiums for low carbon or regenerative products, lower financing rates or insurance rates for farmers. We need both the origin and destination countries to put in place policy measures that encourage and reward regenerative practices and discourage practices that are particularly harmful to the environment and to ecosystems. For large staple food commodities, one of the key challenges is that consumers are price sensitive. So generally, when you're buying your baguettes or your rice, you're not thinking about how sustainable it is. We need to have ways to inform the consumer about the footprint of the products they're buying so that they can make informed choices. Quite simply, we need the consuming markets to be willing to pay just that little bit extra for regeneratively farmed products. We've recently added regenerative agriculture practices to the sustainable farming practices that we promote across our supply chains, and we've really seen that it works. Can regenerative agriculture feed the world? Absolutely. In fact, I think it's the only way that we will be able to feed the world. If regenerative agriculture is taken to scale, as consumers, we can expect to see greater stability in food supply. Perhaps that might translate into greater stability in food prices. As society, we have an incredible ability to innovate in the face of challenges. So I am hopeful that if we combine the power of innovation, of traditional knowledge and data, we're going to be able to implement ever more sustainable and resilient food and agri systems.